Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to bind data to the Angular Gantt chart. I can bind three types of data to a Gantt chart: hierarchical data, self-referential data, and remote data. I will show you how to bind them one by one. First, I open my existing application where I have installed the Angular Gantt package and all the modules of the Gantt chart are configured in App Module page. In App Component HTML page, I have added the basic rendering code of Gantt chart. You can refer to my Angular Gantt chart getting started video to learn more about configuring the component. I've shared a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let's see how to bind data to the Gantt chart. In the data.ts file, I have defined the hierarchical object, project new data, with a collection of tasks. To a single task, I have added fields like task ID, task name, and so on. I have also added the subtasks field to define the child tasks. I have added other tasks as well, with appropriate parent and subtasks. Now I'm going to bind this hierarchical data to the Gantt chart component. Within the app component class, I import the project new data and assign it to the public variable data. In the appComponent.html page, I assign that project data to the dataSource property of the Gantt chart component. Then I must map the necessary dataSource fields to find the project task values using the task fields property. Within the appComponent class, I declare a variable task settings and map dataSource fields to the task values such as ID, name, start date, end date, duration, and progress. I map the subtasks field from dataSource to the child property. At last, I add the dependency property in the task field settings and map the predecessor field from dataSource. Then I assign this variable to the task fields property. Let me run this application. See here, Gantt chart is rendered with a project timeline to represent the project duration. Let me explain how to bind self-referential data to the Gantt chart component. I have added self-referential data in the data.ts file. I can bind self-referential data using a data structure that contains the ID and parent ID mapping fields. Notice here, the task ID field contains unique values used to identify each task, and it should be mapped to the ID property. The parent ID field contains values that indicate parent tasks, and it should be mapped to the parent ID property of the Gantt chart. In addition to these two fields, I have added the usual task values, task name, start date, end date, duration, and progress. Within the app component class, I import the self data from data.ts file and assign it to the variable data, which is assigned to the dataSource property. In the task field settings, most of the dataSource fields mapped are the same as the self data object fields. I'll change the casing alone. In addition to these fields, I need to map the parent ID field. With this method of binding, we don't need to set the child property, so I will remove it. Check out the Gantt chart now. The self-referential data is shown. To bind remote data to a Gantt chart, I need to access the online data service with the help of the Data Manager. The Data Manager is a Syncfusion library that acts as a gateway and interacts with both local and remote data sources. In this example, I'm going to use the Web API adapter to bind data. Within the App Component class, I import the Data Manager and Web API adapter from the Syncfusion/EJ2 data package. I'll comment out the statement that imports the local data from the file data.ts. Now, I replace this local data object with the Data Manager instance. To interact with a remote data service, the Data Manager requires the following minimum configuration, URL, and adapter. I provide the endpoint URL in the Data Manager with a valid service URL to fetch data. This is the online service that I'm going to use in my application. Then I need to specify the adapter type. The adapter is responsible for processing the response from the service endpoint and the request to it. Set the adapter with the Web API adapter, as the service URL passed to the data manager is created based on the Web API standards. Then enable the cross-domain property. Then I map the remote data fields to the task field settings. Since it is hierarchical data, I map the subtasks field from the remote data source to the child property and remove the end date property. Now you can see the remote data displayed in the Gantt chart component. In this video, I have shown you how to bind hierarchical, self-referential, and remote data to the Gantt chart component. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. There, you'll also find a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which provides a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.